Welcome back from that quick break. I know you couldn't wait to get back because we asked this lovely couple a very exciting question. All the ladies out there, I know you want to know what words are those that I should follow, that we should follow, to know that this man, this gentleman is really serious. Lovely red in black and red. By the way, you're very smart. I didn't say that. Is it Valentine's Day for you?
Like not every, really. I think it was... Not really. It was, I think,
a coincidence
that I ended up in these colors.
Like you said, love is in the air. So getting back to our question, how did he exactly approach? Which words did he use to, you know, tell, okay, I think he's truly the one?
Actually, when he approached me, he was like, I've been looking at you several times because I minister in the choir. So he was telling me. So he was telling me, I've been watching you and I think you have God in you. And so I've been praying about it and I'm getting different revelations about you. So this is a confirmation to me that you're really the one. So I want you to be my world. He usually uses that word, my world. Why? Because he thinks I'm everything to him.
So this is someone, a friend you just know from church, and they're saying all this to you. So what did you think? What was your reaction? Is this a game? Is he actually just, you know, what were you thinking at the moment?
Actually, at first I didn't really take it serious. You know why? Because I had this fear in me that sometimes Nigerians, they are very smart. So maybe he organized different he organized a lot of words to approach me with all that to entice me. But I told him, since we both know God, let me pray about it. Still, I'll get confirmation. So as I prayed about it and also getting different revelations, I confirmed he is the one.
So how long did it take after revealing yourself to her that day? How long did it take for her reply, the positive reply you would have liked?
Actually, as I told you, one thing before I answer that, I would like you to know
yes.
What prompted her to, there was no delay in our relationship,
okay.
It was fast. The reason why was, there was no two revelation, there was no two word. What I told her from day one is what I still tell her today.
So too fast is not scary for you?
So for me, what I told her right from the day I met, I told her, you are my word. What I told her same day is what I told her on my introduction day, and that is what I tell her every morning, you are my word. Why I remind her is so that she will not lose it. It's not, there's no two vision, it's only one vision. She, as long as she's happy, I am happy, because my world revolves around her.
So as you were telling her that day, you had it in mind that this will truly happen, or did you think, oh dear?
Before I married her, I knew I would marry her. So when I was telling her I will marry you, I wasn't telling her with a confusion, with doubt. So sometimes she might come back with some things that is not really in line with what I want to hear. I would tell her, don't worry, because it's like I saw the future, so I wasn't concerned with the temporary things that was happening. So for me, when I was talking to her, I was telling her future, not today, because I've lived today already.
Okay.
So tomorrow is what I'm after. So when I wake up every day, I tell her about tomorrow.
Okay.
I'm less concerned about today, because so long as we wake up today, God will provide for today. Whatever you need to live happy, whatever you need to live good, God has already provided it. So for her, what really made her not to, she didn't really want it, but she saw the boldness in me. The boldness in me is not natural. It's, for me, my love for her is beyond. Whenever I see her, I don't talk to her as if, I talk to her with a command, a lovely command, like,
oh.
I proclaim, this is what I like. Why? Because I already knew it right from the first day that this is it. And even when I prayed about, because I've prayed for wife for a long time, since 2014.
Since 2014.
I've been praying for a wife. So she came in 2015, and we dated for 1 year.
So she's the first serious lady you've approached?
Not actually. She was the one that was fabricated for me.
Oh.
God fabricated her for me. You know, when yours comes, every other thing clears way for you. Even God prepares way for you to marry. He prepares way for you to live good life because you've met the one you want. And there is one thing I want to say to viewers back home. When you meet your wife, every other person that is not your wife will live your life without quarrel, without struggle. Every other person that is not meant to be in your life, they will live without struggle. When I met her, I had other ladies that I had as friends. Because at that stage, I don't know what I want. Is it this one? Is it this one? But when it got to a time to marry, I set my vision very clear. And from my vision, who is in line with it? This really guided me, like, where I'm going to, who has this potential. Because marriage is all about purpose in life, fulfilling purpose in life. A marriage that is not purposeful, love can be there, but love will not keep your marriage.
Oh,
but purpose will.
Love.
Yeah, purpose will. And when you see most relationship, the reason why people divorce is because they go out of purpose. So long as you stay in purpose, purpose will keep you. Because sometimes marriage is not about what you feel, it's not about what your emotion, it's all about the purpose. So long as you remain in purpose, your marriage will last forever.
So break it down for us, the purpose you're talking about.
For us, when I met her, because one thing is, she knew my visions. So for her, she had purpose in life. So in as much as she had to make a decision about marriage, she had to check if my purpose in life suit hers. It's one of the ways you confirm if this person is my wife or this person is going to be my husband. You have to look at your purpose in life. Does this suit with this person's purpose? You know, it really helped us a lot. So I would say purpose, our purpose was defined and it matched.
Okay. So what did you find that was his purpose? And purpose, you know, the word purpose is being said. So, what is his purpose in life?
Actually, for our relationship, we know at one time we have to be in a ministry serving God. So, if I'm a minister, he is a minister. We both serve in the church. So, that is the purpose.
That is lovely. It's the same. I don't need to ask you. I heard you say he was in choir.
No, I'm the one who is in
choir. You were in the choir. You are singing. Okay, later on I'm going to ask you to do a task for me. But before I do that, I would love for you to actually give the viewers out there, those who are having hard time in these relationships, they cannot tell if, should I go ahead and say yes to this gentleman, to this lady? You know, like, at some point it gets serious. But there are always some obstacles that come into the way and you start having doubts. So please help us, including me as the viewers, tell us, advise us, marriage, how what it takes, how to get there, to all those who are actually ready for it. Yes, we shall start with the lady.
Actually, there is a difference between relationship and marriage. Because sometimes you can be in a relationship and you don't make it for marriage. But while you're in a relationship, you really need to pray to God to give you guidance. Because sometimes you can meet many men, and among those men there is none that is supposed to be your husband. So with my own experience, I was very patient. I didn't just want to be jumping up and down with every kind of man. I was very patient, and during my patience, I was prayerful. I was very prayerful. Because if you meet one man and he is not serious, there is a prayer you can pray for God really to confirm it. If he is not the one, exactly, if he's not the one, you tell God even for him to go away. And for sure, after your prayers, it will come to pass. If he's not meant to be yours, he will leave. Any fact,
just like you said it, he will leave.
Yeah,
simply.
He will leave. And also another factor is to be hardworking, because normally ladies, they wait for men to give. So they learn into relationships which are not meant to be theirs. But if you're hardworking, you have your own money, you really don't look at any man to come your way because you need his money or anything. So if the right man comes, he will find you with your own, and then you, with and plus what he has, you build on that.
Okay,
so hard working is one, has to be a priority for anyone waiting for
a husband. I have tip of my head, tip of my toes. Please, I hope you're noting this down. Let's move to the gentleman. Please, some tips for me.
For ladies, viewers watching back home, there is only one advice I have for you. Write your purpose in life. When you write your purpose in life, your husband is just very close by. The reason why ladies lose it or men lose it is because they don't have a purpose. They just want somebody to come into their life and fulfill everything they desire. People keep desiring life in mediocrity. But if we can sit down and write purpose, at the end of every 6 months, whether be it relationship, whether be it career, whether be it anything, you will know what you've achieved. You will know what you've not achieved. You will know what next to do. Purpose will help you. It will give you a guideline of what to do. It will give you a guideline of where you are missing it. It will trace, it will help you to retract your track. So I would say for me, people who want to go into a relationship or people who are already in a relationship, the best way to know if this is my man is get your vision down and let him guess his down. Does it fall in line? Where is he going? Is he in the same direction? If he's not in the same direction, love is nothing. It's only purpose. Okay. It's only the vision. Love is, people can be infatuated. Love fluctuates. Some day is high, some day is low.
Yes. Now, ladies and gentlemen, that was a lovely couple for you, Nigeria and Uganda, Mr. and Mrs. Bihan, Obihan Patrick. I was going to call it Obina. I know we watch very many Nigerian movies. Anyways, ladies and gentlemen, that was the lovely couple getting us through their love journey, giving us all the tips. I hope you picked up something, because I have. Now, if you want to look, if you would love to look like I, like she said, looks do matter. Though it's not all that matters, but looks do matter. If you would love to look as lovely as I am, well, the only place to go is where? Jeffy's Salon, Tinder Road, opposite Standard Chartered Bank. They will do your hair any way you want it. Very lovely. You will have a very nice day. If you have a bad hair, do trust me, once you go there, you will have the greatest day. I'm having a very nice day. Yes, and we right here are at Benridge Lounge in Chisasi. They have very nice interior. It's actually a really nice lounge. You can come and have parties. It's affordable. It's wide enough. It's a nice interior, nice paintings, nice chairs, any drink you want. You want to have a wedding. Actually, they have a big compound for weddings, any event you want. And if you also like want to shoot, maybe acting, this is a really nice place to go to for any events you'd want to hold. So Benridge and Chisasi. So just to sum it up, guys, I am thanking my crew, WBS, most especially my guests today. You've taught me a lot. You've taught us a lot. And thank you very much for giving us this time. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you, viewers, ladies and gentlemen, for spending this lovely time with us as we took you through the lovely journey of this lovely couple, Nigerian, Ugandan. I am going to look for... Nigerian. Hope you picked up some really important tips for your relationship. You've learned how really true love is. It's not all about love, like he said. To get to marriage, you have to be patient, prayerful, hardworking, look good, like me. Anyway, till next time, I'm going to thank my crew, WBS crew, where they do really good work. I'm your host, Edith Victoria, Memory Lane, your show. Bye. Have a lovely evening. Thank you.
Does it?